गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम टीचिंग चैप्टर टू एंड नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर टू इज द कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ फूड. एंड यस्टरडे आई टोल्ड यू सेवन न्यूट्रिएंट्स आर वेरी एसेंशियल फॉर द बॉडी, दैट इज द कार्बोहाइड्रेट्स, फैट्स, प्रोटीन्स, विटामिन्स, रफेस दैट इज द फाइबर, मिनरल सॉल्ट्स, वाटर. So and you know that carbohydrates, fats and proteins, these are very important. So yesterday I told you about the activity 1, and activity 1 was to show the presence of proteins in food. And today I will discuss about the activity 2, and name of the activity 2 is the to show the presence of sugar or glucose in food. Lesson 2, components of food, and today I will discuss activity 2, components of food, and today I will discuss about activity 2 is the to show the presence of sugar or glucose in food. So this is the activity 2, to show the presence of sugar or glucose in food. So what do you need for the activity? What do you need for the activity? So for the activity, you know that we need crushed piece of potato and apple. You can take potato or apple. You will take crushed piece of potato or apple, and then you will take the here glucose solution. You will take here glucose solution, and then you will take Benedict's solution, and after that, and you will take Benedict's solution in the 3 different test tubes. You can take Benedict's solution in the 3 different test tube. You can see that this is a different test tube. I will show you, I will draw the diagram, then you can easily understand. So what do you need for the activity? Potato or apple, crushed piece of potato or apple. Then you will take glucose solution and Benedict solution in the 3 different test tubes. And then burner also you will need. And how to do the test? How you will do test? So take crushed piece of potatoes and apple and glucose solution in the 3 separate test tubes. 3 separate test tubes are here, and you will take 3 different test tube, and in these 3 different test tube you will take crushed pieces of potato or apple, and then you will put glucose solution in the 3 separate test tubes, and then you will add few drops of Benedict's solution. Then you will add few drops of Benedict's solution in each test tube. After some time, you will gently heat the solution test tube. What do you observe? You will observe the test tube containing crushed apple and glucose solution turn into the red precipitates, and no such changes occurs in the test tube containing potato, and formation of a red precipitate indicates the presence of sugar. So in this, when you will take crushed apple, then it is turns into the red precipitate, and when it is turns into the red precipitate, that means glucose, presence of sugar in the first test tube. And when it is, and when sugar or glucose is present, when it, then it will change into the red precipitate, and the test also indicates that potato does not contain sugar, and then you can see that it will not change into the sugar. So you can see that in activity 2, to show the presence of sugar or glucose in the food. So for the activity, what do you need? What do you need? You need potato or apple and glucose solution and Benedict solution. And you will take 3 test tubes, and in first test tube you will take apple solution and glucose solution, and when you will put Benedict solution, then it changes, it turn into the red precipitate when you will take glucose and apple in first test tube, then it will change into the red precipitate, and when it will change into the red precipitate, that means it contains sugar or glucose. And in second test tube, when you will put potato and glucose solution, then it will not change its color, that means potato does not contain sugar, and apple, it contain sugar. So by this activity, it is proved that presence of sugar in the food. So by applying this method, you can find out it is it contains food materials are given, it contains sugar or not. So this is the method, and by this method you can do the test. I think all of you understood. Now come to the activity. Next activity is the to test the presence of starch in food. To test the presence of starch in food. I will tell you activity 2. Test the activity 3 here. Activity 3. To test the presence of starch. To test the presence of starch in food. Presence of starch in food. To test the presence of starch in food. So this is the activity 3. And what do you need? What you need for the activity? What you need for the activity? Then you will take slice of bread or potato, slice of bread or potato, and you will take iodine solution. You will take iodine solution and you will take dropper. Iodine solution and you will take dropper. So for the activity, you will take slice of bread or potato, iodine solution and dropper. So how to do the test? First, you will place a drop of iodine on the food sample. You will take the food sample. It can be slice of bread or it can be potato piece. And when you will put iodine solution on the food sample, and what do you observe? You will observe that blue-black color when iodine solution is applied, indicating the presence of starch. When the food sample changes into the blue-black color, then that means starch is present in the given food sample. And when it is not changed into the blue-black color, that means starch is not present in the given food. So this activity is this activity, you can see that it is very easy. How you will do the presence of starch in the food? First, what you will take? You need slice of bread or potato and iodine solution, dropper. And when you will take slice of bread or potato, then you will put iodine solution. And when you will put iodine solution, then you will see that it changes into the blue-black color. Then you will see that it changes into the blue black color, and when it will change into the blue black color, that means it indicates that presence of starch in the given food sample. Presence of starch in the given food sample. So all of you take revision till activity 3, and next activity I will tell you. First you will take revision till here to test the presence of starch in food. I think all of you understood. And what do you need? You can see that this is the materials you need, and you will take revision till here. You will read activity 1, activity 2 and activity 3, and activity 4 I will discuss you later to show the presence of fats in food. And till the activity 3 to test the presence of starch in food, you will take revision till here.